माय डियर व्यूअर्स एंड सब्सक्राइबर्स, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, आई एम स्टार्टिंग ए न्यू सीरीज इन जस्ट टू पार्ट्स ऑफ माय फेवरेट टॉपिक स्ट्रेस मैनेजमेंट एंड दिस इज पार्ट वन. टुडे मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल आर फाउंड अंडर स्ट्रेस एंड डिप्रेशन ड्यू टू वन रीजन और अनदर. द लाइफ इज टू फास्ट एंड समटाइम्स इट बिकम्स डिफिकल्ट टू keep pace with the changes taking place every now and then. The increased pressures of modern day living are responsible for creating lot of physical and mental problems which need to be handled properly. Every person in the world do experience stress, depression, pull down, in blue or bummed out at one time or other. But it should be a temporary state of affairs, because if it persists for a longer period or it is too frequent, then it can result in serious health problems. Now we'll discuss definition of stress. If we try to find the real meaning of stress as shown in dictionaries, it is defined as pressure or strain that tends to distort a body, or a state of physical or mental tension or something inducing it. In a broader sense, when we go into the details, we find that stress is a specific response of a body to all non-specific demands. For example, challenges, threats, or expectations, etc. In fact, stress generates by hopes, fears, expectations, or from any change which makes you feel uncomfortable. It can also be defined as a high level of mental arousal or bodily tension that exceeds a person's capacity to cope. Now we'll discuss type of stress. Normally, stress is considered negative, but we have found that there are two main types of stress. One is positive stress and the other is negative stress. Positive stress is also known as U stress. The positive stress generates from positive emotions, and it's very important for our growth and well-being. It generates from positive emotions like pleasure, enthusiasm, excitement, joy, love, or intellectual stimulation. Negative stress is also known as distress. The negative stress generates from negative emotions such as fear, anxiety, hatred, conflict, frustration, guilt, anger, or dissatisfaction. Now I will discuss stress physiology and responses. First, stress response by animals. There are three types of responses in a split second in case of a threat to an animal. Number one, fight. Number two, flight. Number three, freezing by fear. In case of threat to an animal, either he fights back or he runs away. The third response is quite rare. Now, stress response in human body. The human body considers stress as an emergency. And every living being has been blessed with the abilities to cope with temporary state of extreme situations. The responses in the body are very fast. Many hormones start circulating through the bloodstream and reach every organ, activating every cell in the body to gear them up for an action. The liver releases sugar and fats in the bloodstream to provide extra energy. The respiration becomes faster to provide more oxygen. The heartbeat increases and the blood pressure rises to provide blood to all the areas of the body. Nature has gifted us with a blood clotting mechanism, which stops the blood from flowing out in case of injuries. The mechanism is also activated in anticipation of any injury. The body muscles become tense, preparing the person for any strenuous action. These all responses are reserved for very extreme and temporary situations. But If the stress continues for a longer period, then it can adversely affect our body and can result in serious issues like heart disease, asthma, diabetes, obesity, weak immunity, accelerated aging, and even premature death. Now we'll discuss warning signs of stress. The individuals experience stress physically, mentally, emotionally, or behaviorally. In each type of stress, the individual gets a warning signal. So, first, physical stress. Nature has blessed the human being with warning signals of each type of stress so that he could realize it and try to overcome it. The examples of signs of physical stress are tension, headache or migraine, backache, neckache, palpitation, irregular breathing, dry mouth, sweating, cold hands, shakiness, and sleeping disorders. Next is mental stress. You must have seen people making lot of mistakes very frequently or very disorganized in their affairs or lacking power of decision and would keep the matters lingering on instead of finalizing the issues. These are the examples of mental stress, and some warnings are lack of concentration, forgetfulness, lack of coordination, indecisiveness, being disorganized, making mistakes frequently, inability to remember recent events. Next is emotional stress. There are many persons who are found anxious, panicky, having mood swings, sometimes burst in tears, or having various phobias which make them upset all the time. And you will find them totally lacking any sense of humor. They can be termed as examples or signs of emotional stress, like anxiety, phobias, panic, depression, cynicism, mood swings, tearfulness, loss of sense of humor, and excessive worry. Next is behavioral stress. Sometimes you find people smoking or drinking or starting overeating or not eating at all or biting their nails or even pulling their hairs and neglecting their personal appearance all of a sudden. These are the examples of behavioral stress, and signs are increased smoking, increased drinking, overeating, eating nothing, neglecting personal appearance, nail biting, hair pulling, starting lot of things without finishing. Ladies and gentlemen, that's all for today. In the next video, we will discuss its strategies to manage and handle day-to-day stress. Please watch the clip and subscribe my channel. I will also wait for your comments on this short series on stress management. Thank you very much for watching my video.